had attacked the kingdom, the heroes of the Trine had been spirited away to a forbidding wasteland. The heroes' trek through the blistering desert had taken them out of the frying pan and into a digestive system. An enormous worm had emerged from underneath the treacherous sands and swallowed all of them alive.
Oh, we'll find a way out, don't worry. We've seen worse than this.
Yes, although we've never seen the insides of worse than this.
Can you hear me? I've little fireball-throwing children, just like you have your slime-slinging baby wormlings.
But Amadeus's voice could not carry very far. And even if it could, it was unlikely that the worm cared much for anything its lunch had to say.
Disgusting tentacle things.
Did you notice that we're moving? It's like this worm is headed somewhere.
Hark ye, a dark foretelling, the doom of this oasis dwelling. First rebellion fires powers, then a giant worm devours. Tree and goblin in the land, till nothing here is left but sand. I spoke so unkindly of Margaret, just mere moments before they took her. I'm a horrible person.
She wasn't exactly radiating love and comfort earlier.
She's very brave, my little darling, putting up that prickly, steely exterior in the face of danger.
Sure, like a regular Iron Maiden.
heroes arrived at a pool of gastric acids.
No. Why is it boiling? What did we do?
So the worm decided to get rid of the meddling lunch that had proved too much to swallow. Free of the clutches of the giant sandworm, Amadeus, Pontius, and Zoya, Wyvern flew away, leaving the heroes in the middle of a forbidding dustland.